What's up YouTube, Saf here on SuperSaf TV, and the Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus are finally official. And in this video, we're gonna be taking a detailed look at them, all of their new features, and also comparing them to each other because there are more differences between the two compared to what we had last year. So in terms of the design, it is an incremental update, and if you are expecting something drastically different, then you will be disappointed. We've got a metal frame with curved glass panels on the front and back. Personally, I'm not too disappointed, and that's because the S8s are still some of the best looking devices out right now. Both devices are IP68 water and dust resistant, which is great. And we've got four colors this year: midnight black, titanium gray, coral blue, which we initially saw on the Samsung Galaxy Note 7, as well as lilac purple, which I am surprisingly digging. Now, as always, there are gonna be certain colors available for certain markets, so you may or may not get the color you're after. When it comes to size, the S9s are very similar to the S8s, so if you've handled the S8 or S8 Plus, then you'll be very familiar with the size of the S9 and S9 Plus. The S9 is definitely the more comfortable device to hold in one hand. The screen sizes are also the same, 5.8 inches for the S9 and 6.2 inches for the S9 Plus. However, we do have slightly smaller bezels compared to last year. Based on early leaks, it did look like we were gonna get slightly larger bezels, which I know a lot of you guys were disappointed about, but thankfully we've got smaller bezels compared to last year. They're still Super AMOLED with a Quad HD Plus resolution and an 18.5:9 aspect ratio. So they're sharp, very vibrant with deep blacks, definitely some of the best displays on the market right now. One of the new things that we have in terms of the software is that when you are in landscape mode, then everything's gonna go in landscape mode, including the home screen and the app drawer. This is something that we didn't have last year. Whether or not this is gonna come with an update to the S8s, I'm not too sure. Both the S9 and S9 Plus are powered by either the Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 processor or the Samsung Exynos 9810. Now, which one you get will depend on your region. And we know that the 845 with the Adreno 630 gives 30% faster graphics rendering and is 30% more power efficient compared to last year. So this should give a nice boost in performance for the S9s. And of course, we will be doing lots of SuperSaf style speed tests as soon as we've got the retail versions of the S9s in hand. My buddy Danny Winget has done some early benchmark tests with an 845 reference device, which really shows how much improvement we have. I'll link to that video in the description below. And if you wanna find out more about the 845 and the features it enables on devices like the S9s, there will also be a link in the description below. Now, this is kind of where the similarities between the S9s stop, and that is because the S9 comes with 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of base storage, whereas the S9 Plus comes with 6 GB of RAM and 128 GB of base storage. Last year, as you guys know, with the S8 and S8 Plus, they were practically the same device apart from the size and all of the differences that come with the size. But this year, things are different. With the additional RAM of the S9 Plus, it should be better for multitasking, and that additional storage is always beneficial, although you can expand the storage by up to 400 GB on both devices via the micro SD card slot. Now let's talk about the cameras, which are probably the highlight of these devices. Firstly, we do have a single camera on the S9 and a dual camera on the S9 Plus. The primary camera is the same on both devices, and Samsung is calling this the camera reimagined. And the reason for that is that it's got a dual aperture. So as well as having an f1.5 aperture, which is the widest aperture on any smartphone right now, and it's gonna let in 28% more light compared to the S8 last year, it's also got a 2.4 aperture, and it's gonna mechanically change between these two. If you look closely, you can actually see this happening, which is absolutely insane on a smartphone. And the thinking behind this is that when you are in low light situations, it's gonna use the f1.5 aperture. But if you're in a situation where there's more than 100 lux of light, then it's gonna use the f2.4 aperture to give you a better exposed shot and have more things in focus. We've also got multi-frame noise reduction. And what that basically means is each time you press the shutter, it's gonna take 12 images, and then it's gonna combine those to give you 30% less noise. So for low light, these cameras should be absolutely epic. And of course, we'll be doing lots of SuperSaf style camera comparisons as soon as we've got the retail units in hand. And definitely let me know in the comments below which smartphone you'd like me to compare these with. In terms of the resolution of the camera, it's 12 megapixels. We've got optical image stabilization, and we've still got the dual pixel autofocus, which is fast as, yeah. Now, as mentioned, with the S9 Plus, we do have a second camera, and this is a telephoto camera with an f2.4 aperture, kind of similar to what we had with the Samsung Galaxy Note 8. And this is gonna give you optical zoom, but as well as that, it's gonna give you live focus, which is the portrait mode that Samsung has. It's gonna let you blur the background to give you a DSLR looking shot. And the good thing is that you can adjust the blur after the fact, and it's also gonna take two shots. It's gonna take one from telephoto camera as well as the wide angle camera, so you can always switch between the two later as well. Now, unfortunately, live focus is not here on the S9 because we just have the single camera. There is selective focus, but that is not gonna be working as well as live focus because there is no dedicated second camera. With the new chipsets, we have improvements in terms of video, 4K at 60 frames a second, as well as super slow-mo. Now, super slow-mo is at 960 frames a second at 720p. Now, this is just a burst, so it's not gonna be a continuous recording. It's just gonna be a quick burst, something similar to what we saw on the Sony Xperia devices last year. Now, the problem that I had with the Sony devices last year was that you had to press it at the exact time when you wanted the motion to be captured. And more often than not, you just end up missing that motion. With the S9s, you have something called automatic motion detection. This is gonna let you select a square within your shot, and then you can just press the button, and as soon as it detects motion within that square, that's when it's gonna start recording, and this is gonna make it much easier for you to capture that burst of 960 frames a second. From the demos that I tried, it did look very, very promising. The S9s are also gonna be adding music to your super slow-mo shots automatically, and then you can convert those into GIFs to share, and you can also use them as live wallpapers. The front-facing camera is 8 megapixels with an f1.7 aperture as well as autofocus, but this year we do have selfie focus. So this is basically a portrait mode where it's gonna blur the background, similar to what we've seen on the iPhone 10 as well as the Google Pixel 2. And in my brief testing, it did seem to work pretty well. How well it works compared to the others, we'll find out very soon. Now, we've got some very good news in the audio department. Firstly, we do have a 3.5mm headphone jack. Thank you, Samsung, thank you. Now, this is something that's becoming practically extinct in the smartphone world these days, and it's great that we still have this on the S9s. I'm somebody who does use a 3.5mm headphone jack often, as I'm sure a lot of you guys are too. And in addition to that, we now have stereo speakers. With the S8s, we had a single bottom-firing speaker, which sounded okay, but not great. Now we have stereo speakers tuned by AKG. There is one speaker in the earpiece and one bottom firing. These speakers are 1.4 times louder compared to the S8s last year, and they also incorporate Dolby Atmos surround sound, so you're gonna get a much more immersive experience, and you can switch off Dolby Atmos via the notification toggles and go through some different modes. Now, when it comes to security, a lot of you guys will be pleased to know that we have a fingerprint scanner in a much more reachable position this year. Last year on the S8s as well as the Note 8, we had a fingerprint scanner which was very high, right next to the cameras, and very difficult to reach, especially on the larger devices. This year we have it underneath the cameras in the center. In addition to the fingerprint scanner, we still have the iris scanner as well as facial recognition, but this year we have intelligent scan. Intelligent scan is gonna use both the iris scanner as well as facial recognition combined to give you enhanced security. And this is thanks to the secure processing unit on the new chipset. Now, we have a new feature on the S9s, which I know some of you guys will have some comments about, and it's called AR Emoji. So AR Emoji is basically a 3D caricature of yourself on your phone, and it's gonna make this by using a picture of yourself. Now, mine didn't work too well in the demo, so I'm probably gonna have to try it again and do some more tweaks. But once you have your AR Emoji in place, the S9s are gonna look for 100 facial features and give your AR emoji realistic expressions. You'll then be able to share those with your friends and family using things like WhatsApp and Facebook. Both the S9 and S9 Plus come with Android Oreo out of the box with the Samsung Experience skin. And then we've got Bixby, Samsung's AI assistant. If you wanna find out more about Bixby, I have done a dedicated video, which I'll be linking in the cards. And this year we've got some improvements, especially with Bixby Vision. You've got some new features like Live Translate, which is gonna let you point your camera at text and it's gonna translate that for you live. Very useful if you're abroad, and I'll probably be using it in Barcelona for MWC. And you can also point your camera at food and it's gonna give you more information about that food, such as how many calories it has. Now, looking at the batteries, we've got the same size batteries as we had last year. So 3000 mAh for the S9 and 3500 mAh for the S9 Plus. Now, although they're not any bigger compared to last year, because of the new chipsets, they should be more efficient. And we still do have fast charging as well as fast wireless charging, which is great to have. Now, finally, looking at the price, we do have a price increase compared to last year, especially for the S9 Plus. And the S9 Plus is coming in at the same price that the Note 8 was released at. So definitely a premium price tag here and a bigger gap between the S9 and S9 Plus because of the additional features that we have on the S9 Plus this year. Pre-orders are gonna be going live today with an official release date of the 16th of March, Although if you do pre-order early, then you should be getting your device early too. So there we have it guys, the much awaited Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus. Both very promising devices. We have an incremental update in terms of the build and design, but we do have some improvements, especially in terms of the camera. I cannot wait to test it out. What do you guys think of the Samsung Galaxy S9 and S9 Plus? Definitely drop me a comment below and let me know. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, then do hit that thumbs up button. And as mentioned earlier on, we are going to be having a lot of more S9 coverage here on the channel. If you want to see that first, then make sure you have subscribed and switch on notifications. Thanks for watching. This is Saf on SuperSaf TV, and I'll see you next time.